Hey all, and welcome to another video. So today we are going to set up our Intercom Villa station and we're going to be adding users to it so we can use fobs and cards to access the property. Okay, so we won't be adding a mega lock or anything like that in this video, but we're going to get you prepared so it's all ready to go for when you get to that stage. Okay, so I've got my door station here. I've got my main screen here, but we won't be using this on this video. So the door station is set to default. Just added it, just gave your IP address and a password. All right, that's it, guys. So normal things first, set the time, NTP, please, daylight savings time. All right, that's done. Now, there are different ways to do it. You can add people through IVMS, but I'm going to add someone on the user menu direct onto the door station. Now, I find this method to be a lot better than adding a user and the other method, but basically it's best that you learn both ways, guys. I mean, the more you know, the better it is. Okay, so but we'll be adding it through this way. Check out our previous videos on another way, but I think it's I like this way, and I'm gonna go with it. Okay, so normal floor one, room one. All right, the start date and end date is pretty interesting, guys. So as you see, it's only giving us 10 years access. All right, now I can maybe, let's just see if I can go ahead a few more years. Now on the IME one, the modular door station, if you set this up, it will give you basically unlimited time. You'd have to do this, but for some reason on this one, okay, you see now I've exceeded the time duration, which is quite interesting. So let's go to the maximum. Okay, it seems like December 37 is the maximum. Okay, so I have figured out that in about 10 years, guys, there's gonna be a lot of intercoms out there that are just gonna stop working one day because most of them have been set to 10 years. And now this is just how it is, I'm afraid. So do be careful. And if your intercom does go off, then it is a simple fix. You can just log on to your user and then just change the time, okay? But I know a lot of you won't be able to do that, but installers out there, you might get a lot of inquiries in about 7 or 8 years. Just a heads up there. All right, but now we've added our user almost, and now with the card settings is the bit we need to look at. So we're going to go add card, and now this is so easy, guys. We're going to go read, and then I'm going to run over to my door station. I've got my fob in my hand. I'll show you the fob in the live demo later on. Put it over the card reader. There we go, and it should have added a number. Yes, it added a number. Okay, so that is the number from the fob. It's taken it. We go okay, and as you see, we have one card on here. You can add up to 5 cards per user. Okay, so we're just going to go okay, and now it's saved, succeeded. We have a user on here. Now I'll flip over to the live view, guys, and it should be a piece of cake to show you how it works. So I'll catch you in a sec. Okay, as you see here, I just use a generic fob. It's a fob that we bought from a supplier over in China. I mean, I thought I'd use this. If this works, anything should work. But obviously, you can get official Hikvision ones, or you can get the cards. And I think one comes in the pack, so you've got something to test on. Right now, we're going to hear those magical words, door open. Let's hope so, anyway.
The door is open.
Yep, the door is open. Okay, so that means we're ready to go ahead and configure our lock now. Okay, so whatever lock we configure it, as soon as you go like this,
the door is open.
It's going to open it. All right. So stay tuned, and we're going to have some lock configurations coming up on the next video. So catch you there. Thank you. Goodbye.